Paris is possibly the most known map in the latest Hitman trilogy, and for a lot of us, it was our first experience in this new era of Hitman. Consistently rated among the best Hitman maps of all time, Paris is easily a fan favourite. In this video, I'll be taking a look at Paris from two different early builds of Hitman 2016, documenting map changes, opportunities, dialogue, and other things that might be interesting. So let's start.
Good evening, 47. Your destination is the Paris Fashion Show by Sanguin, one of Europe's leading couture brands. Your targets are Sanguin owner Viktor Novikov, a former oligarch turned fashion mogul, and his partner Dalia Margolis, a retired supermodel, an iconic power couple on the global fashion scene, and two of the most dangerous people in the world. Novikov and Margolis are in fact the ringleaders of Iago, an enigmatic spy ring that deals in the global elite's most valuable secrets. Unscrupulous and opportunistic, Iago has caused disastrous security leaks all over the globe. When Crimean separatists caused a deadly meltdown at the Odessa nuclear power plant, Iago gave them access to the plant security network. And when the Delgado drug cartel shot down the plane of President Hernandez and his family, Iago provided the classified flight plans. Now Novikov and Margolis have obtained a knock list of British undercover agents, which they plan to sell at a secret Iago auction during the Sanguin show. So our client, MI6, need us to stop the ringleaders before the knock list ends up in the wrong hands. The Sanguin show will be swarming with security, and Viktor Novikov will be the focus of everyone's attention. But despite his posturing, he is merely the money man. The real target is Dalia Margolis, beautiful and brilliant. She is a master manipulator and the true brains behind Iago. Two targets, a highly public event. At first glance, an impossible task. Then again, I do know how you love a challenge. I will leave you to prepare.
Guards use flashlights in the attic. To access the auction using an invite, you need to show your auction invitation once outside and once on the second floor.
Okay, you can go through.
Just take a minute, no need to worry. We're the good guys, right? All right, good job, sir. Thank you. I'd like to see your invitation, sir. And you're good to go. Thanks a lot.
There was only two kitchen staff in the kitchen, and one of them had a different outfit compared to the other. Crates that 47 could conceal items into were removed from several places on the map. These crates would be moved by NPCs from one area to another.
Thank you.
If the auction gets interrupted, the Sheik would stand on the balcony for a smoke while he waits. The Sheik spawns outside by his helicopter instead of in his room like the final game. He then heads up to his room before going to the auction. The Sheik has several lines of dialogue not seen in the final game, including dialogue which reveals who the Sheik really is.
You, where is my escort? Or am I supposed to find the VIP lounge by instinct?
You probably want Dahlia Margolis, Mr.
Your Highness, Sheikh Salman al-Ghazali. Never you mind. I shall call her myself. Sheikh al-Ghazali speaking. I have arrived at the palace, but I failed to see a proper escort. This is the date, am I not correct? Second floor. Very well. I shall be there shortly. VIP, don't be absurd. I am Sheikh Salman al-Ghazali. I have no need for identification. Expect my cinnamon mint tea to be served without delay. Goodbye. You, I wish to freshen up.
Certainly, Your Excellency. Please, follow me. Well, this should do. Allow me a moment to secure the room, Your Excellency.
Very well.
All clear. Go ahead, Your Excellency.
What have I gotten myself into? I'm no sheik! But I let Parker talk me into this! Huh. Hey, Abe, you wanna earn some easy bucks? I met this guy, this Saudi sheik who looks exactly like you. I mean, exactly! So anyway, the sheik wants to slip away with a chick for a few weeks, and I thought, Abe's an actor, he can totally do this! Just act like a complete douche all the time and you'll be fine. What could possibly go wrong? Right. Fuck! No, relax, Abe. Relax. Get a hold of yourself. Deep breath, deep breath. You've done Strindberg. You can do this. These people aren't so scary. Probably just misunderstood. Yeah. Enter. Sheik.
Dialogue between a guard and a staff member outside was removed.
So, what are you up to?
Work. Unlike you.
I'm working, you know, I'm serving hors d'oeuvres. These things go like hotcakes, I tell you, you know, running back and forth like a madman.
Uh-huh. That mustard on your lip?
Yes. Yes, it is. You're supposed to taste a few, okay? It's called quality assurance. You know, it's part of the job.
Hold on. I remember you. You served at my daughter's 15th birthday.
No. That wasn't me. You know, I've got one of those faces. It happens all the time.
Uh-huh. Right.
Dialogue between a guard and another NPC in the museum was removed.
Fashion is just an illusion for the masses. It's based on the false promise that style is something you can buy. It's bullshit, basically.
No offense, but it sounds like you might not be in the right line of work, miss.
Everyone wants to work in fashion. It's just something you do. Even if I'm only an assistant, there's a million kids out there who would eat their own grandmothers for a shot at my position. And do it for free.
Yet, you're way out here talking to me. A guy who wears white tees and cargo pants when he's off duty.
Yeah, well, my dad and my brother, they're both cops, so I guess I've always felt comfortable around guys in uniform. Ah, shit. That's my phone. Miriam probably wants a Cosmo. Or someone to yell at. Usually both.
Yeah, my boss is like that. Funny how all jobs are basically the same, you know. Hey, I got this friend who's a stuntman. Greatest job in the world, right? Or so you'd think. Only he says, once you've fallen down a flight of stairs, you've fallen down them all. That really got me thinking.
Yeah. So, I better get back in. It was really nice talking to you. You know my name, so...
Yeah, I got it.
Dialogue between two Iago staff members regarding security in the library was removed.
Hey, you know why the library's been closed off?
What, are you planning on doing some reading? You're gonna have to wait until your shift is over.
No, I was just wondering why it's guarded.
There are so many places guarded here, it's like a bank or something.
Yeah, I heard that.
Dialogue between three guards outside was changed in the final game.
So, hey, how do you get into your line of work? I mean, must be much better paid than we are.
Yeah, we're just like doormen.
With guns.
Yeah, you don't want to do this line of work.
Oh, we do. I mean, the outfits are much cooler, and I bet you get to travel a lot.
But it's a dangerous job. Every day could be your last.
That doesn't sound like fun.
It's not. And you have family at home that worries about you all the time. It's hard work.
But... you know, how did you qualify for the job?
Was in the Foreign Legion. Did some tours in Afghanistan, the Gaza, Iraq.
So you're a hero.
In war, there's no such thing as heroes. Only casualties. So let me give you the best advice I possibly can. Do what you do, and you will stay alive. And your mother will be happy.
Yeah, you're probably right. I think I'm too old to enlist in the Foreign Legion, so...
You're smarter than I thought. Good for you. Stay safe.
A lot of Diana's dialogue has been removed. This dialogue was likely only intended for the Alpha, though.
Sanguine has hired a local security agency. They are allowed ground and first floor access. Sheikh Al-Ghazali is a most private person. Apart from his closest friends and family, few people know what he looks like. Hopefully, neither does Dahlia Margolis. The chef is allowed access to the basement and ground floor. As a technician, you have access to the basement, ground, and first floor, but the second floor remains off limits. Stylists are allowed backstage, but their access is limited to the basement and ground floor. The kitchen staff has access to the basement and ground floor. As a waiter, you can tamper with beverages without arousing suspicion. As an Iago staff member, you have full access to the second floor lounge and the entire palace. As a waiter, you can tamper with beverages without arousing suspicion. That barge is stacked with fireworks. Interesting. A useful escape vehicle, if you can find the key, that is. I'd look in the palace owner's private quarters. Only security, technicians, and Iago staff are allowed on the first floor. A pyrotechnician's remote. It triggers the fireworks display.
Huh. Wow. You know why the
library's been closed? Iago's auction is strictly invite-only. You need to show a VIP card to gain access. Find one. Or look for a different route inside. That is infamous Sheikh Salman Al-Ghazali. You can smell the haughtiness from miles away. The cameras connect to a security station in the basement, where all recordings are stored. You should be able to bypass guards and security checks by climbing the drain pipes.
Let's compare some of the opportunities between the early build of Paris and the final game. If you've only played Hitman 2 or 3, opportunities are the same thing as mission stories. A drink to die for wasn't developed yet. However, 47 can poison a drink that a bartender will serve to Novikov. private meeting still works in this build, however, with a few changes. Max Decker's appearance was different compared to the final game. This was likely a placeholder though, as this model is seen on other alpha maps. Max Decker waits for Novikov in a different area than in the final game. The meeting with Max Decker and Novikov is initiated differently. Once 47 gets close to Decker, he'll call Novikov and then start to head towards the garden.
Mr. Novikov, Decker here. I'm outside the palace. Well, we could hardly predict the pileup on the freeway, could we? Pavilion Northwest Gardens, next to the helipad. Could you pick something more remote, perchance? I don't know, city catacombs, maybe? Yeah, fine. Inform your guards they were coming through. I'll call you when we get there. Come on, let's stretch our legs. Garson, don't forget the case in the trunk.
Go on, sir. I'll be right behind you. What the hell? Shit, keys. Oh, God damn it! They were right here! Just had them in my hand. Come on! Well, I guess somebody up there likes me.
Finally, we can get on with things. I hope you've learned something today, Carson. Mr. Novikov, I'm at the pavilion. Fine. Please hurry before my parking expires.
Mr. Decker, how are things at the office?
That's 91 all over again. Kamarov is found dead, gun in hand, office locked from the inside. In his safe, evidence that he was leaking state secrets to Langley. An FSB section chief, Kremlin's golden boy, a CIA spy. Look, I don't know who you hired to pull this off, but I want his number.
Trust me, you don't. The case file, please.
Right. Of course. Last and only copy. There was an unfortunate server room fire at HQ. Misery loves company.
What's this?
I got you a little souvenir. From Kamarov's office. Ming Dynasty, I believe.
Oh, Mr. Decker. You know, I do believe this is going to be the start of a beautiful friendship. The money's being wired to your account.
Do I need to call my guy in Switzerland?
Why? Haven't you heard? I am an honest businessman. До свидания, Mr. Decker.
The keys to a speedboat must be the one docked at the garden pier.
A quick break still ends the auction, but you don't need a dongle to use the laptop. And that's it for this video. If you want to chat with me or other members of the community, be sure to join the TJGM Discord. And if you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a like. Follow me on Twitter for the latest updates on my videos and other content, and don't forget to subscribe to support the channel.